Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Postman on a Windows operating system. And then I'm also going to show you using an API, like how we can fetch all the data from that API. So do watch the video till the end. And if you like the video, please give it a like and also do subscribe our channel. And if you face any difficulty, please do comment in our comment sections. I'm always there to help you. So let's dive in into our video. So to download our Postman, you need to first simply go to favorite browser, and in that this bar you need to just simply search with Postman download and hit enter, and you will get this www.postman.com as our first search result. So here you need to just simply click on download Postman, and on clicking that, it's going to redirect to the official site of Postman. So here, if you scroll down, you can see that our Windows 64-bit Postman app is rightly available. So if you are using some other operating system, so it's going to, you know, automatically recognize that. Like you can see for Mac or Linux, you can, you know, install Postman. So for Windows, you need to just simply click on this download button and it will going to start downloading our Postman. Okay. So since I have already downloaded it, I'll just simply cancel it. I'll minimize my browser. And I'll just simply go to my download directory, and you can see that the latest version of Postman for Windows 64-bit operating system is already been downloaded over here, and the file size is 163 MB. Alright, so to install, just simply double click on the installer, and you can see that our Postman is currently launching. We can minimize our download directory, and our Postman is rightly launched. So if you are new to Postman, you can, you know, easily create a free account. It's totally free. Or if you have account already, so then you need to sign in. You can just, you know, simply click on create a free account, and it will redirect to the browser. So here you can, you know, provide your email ID, username and password, and you can easily create a free account. I have already an account, so what I'll do is I'll just simply, you know, click on skip and take me to the desktop app. And I'm just going to click on sign in, since I already have an account. So again, it's going to redirect to the browser, and here in the sign in page, I need to provide my email ID and password. So I'll provide my email ID. I'll provide the password. And then I'm just going to click on sign in. So here it will ask you, you know, open Postman on our alert box and browser. So just simply click on open Postman. So it's going to automatically authenticate our Postman. And here you can see our Postman is rightly authenticated over here. So let's minimize our browser and all. I'll maximize the Postman. So this is the interface of our Postman. I have, you know, as a practice, created this couple of workspaces. So similarly, you need to also create a workspace. So for that, you need to just simply hover over this, click over this workspace, and you need to click on this create workspace. So this will open this create workspace window. And here, let's create the workspace as API underscore testing. Okay, you can give summary and all, and here you need to choose personal. If you want to, you know, do a team collaboration project, then you need to choose team, or if you want to keep it private or any other option, then you can choose all that. I'm going to use it for personal, naming it API testing create workspace. So our API testing workspace is rightly created over here. So you can just simply, you know, click on this plus button, and it will going to give you this API testing interface. So here you can see enter request URL. So our API URL you can write over here. So I have a URL called fake store api.com/product. So just simply give that URL, and if you just simply click on send, it's going to fetch whatever is there on that URL. Okay, you can expand this. So here you can see we have ID, title, price, description, category, image, and rating, and also the rate and account. So subsequently you can see the data all are there in following, right? So here we are using this get HTTP verb. If you want to use post, put, or delete, so subsequently you need to click on that and you need to provide that value over here, right? The key and the value as a parameter, right? So let's go back to get. So here is our, you know, data that you have fetched from this API. So let's say you want to open this image, so just simply click on that and it will going to open a new tab and going to paste our URL right over here. So get HTTP verb is correct, just simply click on send. And you can see our image is rightly fetched over here. Right, you can close this. Don't save. Right, so here you can see the status. So 200 okay means it had fetched properly. It is also showing that amount of time it is taking in order to fetch and what is the total size limit of this API. Right, so in this way you can easily test your API on this Postman. So that's basically all about this video. If you need more tutorials on Postman, please do put a comment in our comment sections. I'll be happy to make more tutorials. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like the video, please give it a like and also please do share it with friends. I'll be happy to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.